Well, this is a real teachable moment. A Christian rock festival. There was going to be an openly gay, quote, Christian who was going to be performing. It ended up it wasn't going to happen. And the storyline, the reaction, it tells you a lot about the state of the church and the state of contemporary Christian music today. Here's what the headline said on Billboard.com. Gay Christian rocker Trey Pearson on being ousted from Festival Bill and how he ended up on stage anyway. So Trey Pearson has recently come out as gay, says he's a, quote, gay Christian, and he was all excited with his group. He was going to be performing. He was going to be doing a set at this big Christian rock festival, Joshua Fest. There were well-known bands like Switchfoot and Reliant K, Skillet, Crowder, different bands, and he's saying, hey, overwhelmed and honored. I'm going to be the first openly gay Christian at this event. Well, anyway, there was a backlash. People were not happy with that. Out of 14 key people in the production crew, 11 of them said, we're out of here if he's on. So the guy organizing the whole festival, Aaron Diello, the Joshua Fest owner, said, listen, out of the team of 14, 11 said they weren't going to go along with this. So we had to cancel what he was going to do. But otherwise, the owner was happy to have him on. He said, look, Everyday Sunday, that's the name of the band, has played almost every year of the festival for the past decade. We had booked them for tours, hung out on RV rides after shows, even played Halo together back in the day. We knew it would be controversial, but we also knew that if we were going to claim to be a festival that proclaims the love of Jesus to everyone, then our friend needed to be included in that proclamation. What? With all respect to the desire to show the love of Jesus, this is biblical, theological, and practical nonsense. If you're going to show the love of Jesus to everyone, you're going to have Muslim groups perform. You're going to have atheist groups perform. You're going to have satanic groups perform. You're going to have polygamous groups perform. You're going to have all kinds of other groups perform. You don't show the love of Jesus by including someone whose behavior, whose actions the Bible speaks against, where the Bible says if you want to practice homosexuality, you can't inherit the kingdom, just like if you practice adultery, you cannot inherit the kingdom. And when you show the love of Jesus, you lovingly call those people to repent. You don't feature them in a band. What if one Christian musician had left his wife and now he's shacking up with another lady but still says, I love Jesus and it wasn't the will of God. I was married with this other person. It was the wrong choice. So now I feel unity. I feel blessing. And I got my band and we're going to sing about liberty and Jesus and freedom and love. Are you going to have him on? No, God forbid that you do. And what's amazing is the response of some of the others. Five Iron Frenzy drummer Andrew Verdeccio said this. He said, look, he believes in the same God you do, but you're going to excommunicate him because of his sexuality? Yeah, according to the Bible, lifestyle, practices, choices, relationships, those are very important. If the polygamist or the adulterer or the fornicator or the polyamorist or the bisexual or the homosexual or whoever it is, they can say they believe in the same God, but if they don't follow what Scripture says and they claim to be Christians and they're living in open, blatant sin, the loving thing to do is to disfellowship them and call them to repent. The band singer, Reese Roper, says, we had all talked about as a band about just dropping off of the festival just to make a statement. They're going to drop out of the festival to protest. Like, if you're not going to let them play, then we're not going to play. We don't like to deal with that kind of intolerance. All this guy is doing is speaking the language of the world. All he's doing is buying into the talking points of the world. And check out this. Personally, he says, I feel like the Bible is not clear on it to say. But I do know, it's not clear enough to say, but I do know that it's clear that we're to love each other as Christ loved us. And I don't think the church is doing that. Oh, we could do a better job of loving each other. Oh, we could do a better job of having compassionate care and concern for one another. Sure, let's love our neighbors ourselves in a deeper, more Christ-like way across the board. But you're telling me there's ambiguity in Scripture that the Bible says, yeah, marriage could be two men, two women, a man and a woman. You're telling me there's ambiguity in Scripture? You're telling me there's a single relationship in Scripture, same-sex relationship, blessed by God and smiled on by God or called marriage by God? You're telling me the Bible's not absolutely clear that God made men for women and women for men, period, end of subject? Wow. But All this being said, I'm not in the least bit surprised. And at the end of the festival, Trey Pearson ended up doing a special song with another band, and people thought it was special and wonderful. Hey, I'm glad that people show him that they love him, regardless of who he declares himself to be and how he's living. But this is not the right way to show love, and this is the state of contemporary Christian music today.